The vision for the future is this new purpose-built school, which the use of it is this trust has allowed us to build on the current playground. We've demolished the current playground in readiness for this new school to be built and to go ahead. But unfortunately, as all these projects, we require a lot of funding to make sure it comes to completion. And the new school that we are building is going to be a state-of-the-art 21st century school that will allow our children to gain this opportunity that I was talking about, that yes, you know, we can provide you with this, and inshallah, given the resources that will be in that new building, there should be nothing to hold us back from, you know, getting to where we want to get to. And, you know, the lack of space or things like that should not be a hindrance to where we want to go.
Well, we have a wonderful opportunity, and I am glad, and I feel and happy when I even think about it, that for the first time, a Muslim school who was founded with 15, 16 children, 3 years old, in a small little house, which has grown to be one of the best schools in the country, and now have the chance to grow up to be two form entry school in a fantastic new building, whereby the children will not just have a good place to play, but good classrooms to achieve success in their education and academic learning, plus, for the first time, a purpose-built prayer hall, whereby it is there for really learning about the spiritual path of the human being, entering into it and feeling that joy of being together with everybody. Now we cannot all pray in this place here. Okay? This place is used as a gym sometimes, it's used as a theater sometimes, it's used as an assembly hall, a meeting hall, whatever you can name it. So when the children walk into it as a spiritual hall, they don't have that aura in it. But inshallah, by having that facility, having a beautiful canteen that will be open for the public to come in, and the parents especially, having parent room, SEN room, having, mashallah, the latest technology within the building, I think that is going to help us to be one of the best schools, inshallah, in the future.
Well, Islamic School have proposed a new school build. It's going to have the same ethos, the same Islamic environment. It's just that it's catering for the children of today. It's a modernized building. It fits beautifully within this community. The only difference is it's just bigger. And it will cater for the children. It will give those children a safe playground to play in. It will give them a canteen, which they don't have right now. And it will allow all the children to learn in one environment rather than in two separate buildings.
It's a matter of, not of desire, but of need. And it's a critical need, because the current situation just simply cannot go on as it is, because there's just, the children are suffering and paying the cost of that at the end of the day. And so the new building is something which is absolutely essential for the education of Brent children.
Well, in the new design, for a start, we've got all the key stage one, that's foundation stage, and up to year two, key stage one. They've got all got their own play spaces that leading directly out of their classrooms. So they've got outdoor play. So outdoor learning becomes part of indoor learning as well. It's very free flow in that respect. And then the playgrounds, we've planned and designed the playgrounds to be on the roof so that we gain more play space. And also there are two different types of playground we are able to provide. One will be a quiet playground where there's the garden and sort of quiet areas for the children who do not want to be part of the noisy playground. And on the other side is the activity and adventure playground where children can enjoy their play times and engage in activities which are of a more vocal nature.
Any project that is held by the government, or especially local governments, they would love you to have that building, you know, accessible to the community. To be honest with you, a school is the backbone of the community, because the mother delivers her children. The father either deliver or pick their children up. The parents come to evening that the school arranged. They come to assemblies. They come to the school to ask for advice. My office, and most of them have surgeries for parents, not to do with the school or the children, it's to do with their own spiritual thing, social things. So I think we need to establish within our schools, especially Muslim school, the social infrastructure for helping our community. So inshallah, in our modern building that we're going to have, we're going to have a parent room in which a lot of activities can take place, meeting, discussion, debate, learning, whatever. Then we will have the canteen. It will be open for lunch for the kids, okay? But inshallah, we're going to cater for it. Early breakfast, parents can have breakfast there, okay? And children can have breakfast there. And then we can open it in hours where the children are not eating or drinking, at the cafe. Anybody passing by the street or parents coming in, they can sit and have coffee, have discussion. A businessman could come and bring somebody here in Islamia cafe and have his meeting with whatever partner to discuss with while they're having breakfast or coffee together. After school is finished, from 3:30 onwards, also people can come in and have a sandwich, buy something to drink, have a discussion. Parents can be waiting for their children who are in classes, inshallah, doing extra activities.
My hopes for the new building is that it will be, will set a standard of excellence within Brent, that it will become one of the most inspiring schools within the borough. Obviously, with every with the change, you obviously have like a new mentality, and so it's a matter of taking that energy that you get from that momentum and using it in order to inspire, you know, greater educational opportunities for your children.
This is the next generation that we need to cater for. We've done a lot here, but it can't stop here. It needs to continue. And to be able to continue, we've got to provide them with the means that they need. Who knows where they will end up. So to provide for them is, you know, our duty. We can't leave things here. We need to make this vision a reality, make this school stand, and then let our children go forward, because it won't happen otherwise if we don't take that upon ourselves, that to help your children, to help our children, to help, you know, our ummah. We have to. We just have to do this.